In today's free Affinity Photo Tutorial, I'm going to show you how to take a flat color photograph of an amazing landscape and transform it into an amazing cinematic black and white shot. And I'm going to show you all the steps that you need to do in order to get results like this. So, without any further delay, let's roll the intro. Hello everybody, this is Strato Ayani from illumis.com, the YouTube channel and online academy where we teach you how to take advantage of the gear you already have in order to create amazing photos. So if you're new here, why not consider subscribing? So it has been a few weeks that we took a pause because it was summer, and now we are back with more and amazing ideas plus tutorials for Affinity Photo and photography in general. So stay tuned because we have a lot coming your way in terms of free Affinity Photo tutorials and photography tutorials that we'll start doing from this year moving on forward. But let's stop talking and let's go into Affinity Photo. Okay, as you can see here, I have a very interesting photo, a very interesting landscape photo actually, with a nice waterfall. But the problem here is that it's kind of flat, okay? It's kind of bland, it doesn't look very nice, so I'm going to bring my wireless keyboard over here and I'm going to show you how to create an amazing black and white photo out of this shot, okay? So the first step is the following. All you need to do is go over here and select from the adjustments menu the black and white adjustment. Now, this adjustment will convert instantly in a very nice way your photo from color into black and white, and if you move around these sliders, it's going to give you some control on the contrast of the photo, okay? But I'm not going to be working with this panel right now. All I needed to do is to make the photo black and white, and as you can see, now that it's black and white, it's kind of dull, okay? It's not very, let's say, beautiful, it doesn't look very nice, it's flat and it has one single focal point, which is the waterfall. But we're going to fix that, aren't we? In order now to make this photo look great, you need two things, okay? You need to be able to control the highlights of the photo, which need to be brighter, and you need to control the shadows of the photo that need to be darker, and you're going to actually create a lot of contrast and more visual interest if you make the highlights pop and if you make the shadows a little darker. But in the shadow areas, you need to make sure that you retain your detail and you're not just blacking everything out, okay? And I'm going to show you how to do this in a non-destructive way. All right, let's go. Now, the first thing that I'm going to be using is my favorite tool, the curves, and I'm going to create a new curves adjustment on top of everything else. And I'm going to click here in the middle to create a new control point and click and drag it to the left and upwards. And as you can see, it makes my whole photo brighter, but this is not the point. I want to be able to control which parts of the photo become brighter, okay? And in order to do so, I'm going to hit the X button over here to close this dialog. I'm going to select the curves adjustment. I'm going to click on the mask over here and hit on my keyboard Control I or Command I if you are on a Mac. Now, as you can see, this white rectangular shape over here, which is the mask, became black after I hit Control I. And it's black because I inverted the mask. Now, the mask works as following. I don't know if this is an expression, but here's how the masks work. If the mask is white in a specific area on top of the photo, this specific area of the photo receives an effect, okay? What effect? The effect that my curves adjustment layer does. For example, my curves adjustment layer, if you remember, it makes everything brighter, okay? But I don't want to make everything brighter, I just want to make the highlights brighter. So I'm applying a curves adjustment, I'm making my whole photo bright, and then I'm hiding the effect behind the black mask by clicking over here and hitting Control I. Now, if I want to apply this brightening effect to some specific areas within my frame, all I have to do is go over here, select my paintbrush tool, give an opacity of around 50% for this effect, flow 100% and hardness at 0%, okay? Then click on the curves adjustments over here and make sure that the foreground color, which is the top circular shape over here, is white. If it isn't, you can double click it, select a white color from the top left corner over here, hit close and you're good to go. And now all I have to do is simply use this paintbrush and left click and drag on top of the areas that have highlights. For example, this area over here, this area over here, and this area over here. Now, if you need to make the brush smaller, you hit the left square bracket key. If you want to make the brush bigger, you hit the right square bracket key on your keyboard, or it takes a little more time, but you can go over here and play around with this slider, but doesn't give you a visual representation of how small or large the brush will be. So this is why I'm using the keyboard shortcuts, left and right square bracket key, in order to work faster. And I'm going to apply the effect over here. Now this is a bright area, I'm going to apply it over here as well. As you can see, it makes a whole bunch of difference. And I'm going to click over here on the white spots in order to bring back some detail and some highlights from here as well. Now, once I'm done, and let's paint this area over here and maybe those highlights. As you can see, I'm not actually thinking very hard where and how I'm using the brush, because I'm going to do the next step, which is change the blending mode of the curves adjustment layer that makes everything brighter from normal, okay, to lighten. And then I'm going to apply on this curves adjustment layer a Gaussian blur smart live filter, I'm sorry. So I'm going to select the live filter, so I'm going to click the Gaussian blur, and I'm going to blur this effect in order to make it blend better with the whole scene. Okay, now if you notice this area over here with the three, or actually four, light rays, let's call them like light rays because why not, it looks quite fake. Okay, it looks like a dinosaur put his palm or his feet over there. But if we apply a Gaussian blur on the mask of the curves adjustment layer that creates this effect, it's going to blur out the edges of the brush strokes that I used throughout the whole photo, and it's going to make them blend a lot better with the rest of the photo. And as you can see, it looks a lot better already, okay? How much radius you need, how much you need to push it to the right? Well, it depends on the photo and the brush strokes. My suggestion is to actually push it to the right until it blends nicely within the photo, with the rest of the photo, I'm sorry, okay? Now that I'm done, I can go over here to the curves adjustment and I can double click and take this control point and drag it to the left even more if I want to make these areas become a lot more bright, so this looks quite nice. Or if I overdo it, for example, if I go somewhere around here, then I can click this control point and drag it to the right and downwards in order to decrease the strength of this effect, okay? Now, I'm going to click on the name over here and rename this adjustment layer, and I'm going to name it light areas, okay? And I'm going to do the exact same thing for the black areas. And the process is the same. I'm going to use a curves adjustment layer in order to create an effect that makes the dark areas a lot darker. And then I'm going to use my paintbrush in order to select specific areas within my frame that need to be darker in order to create depth and contrast to make the photo look more cinematic. So I'm going back to Affinity Photo, I'm going to click over here, I'm going to select a curves adjustment layer, and I'm going to actually do the opposite this time. I'm going to click here and drag it, instead of up and to the left, I'm going to drag it downwards and to the right. And as you can see, it makes the photo darker, but I don't want the whole photo to be darker. I just need to make darker some specific areas within my frame, okay? So I'm going to close this window. I'm going to select the mask of this new curves adjustment layer that makes everything darker. I'm going to hit Control I in order to invert the mask and hide the effect throughout the whole frame. And again, I'm going to be using my paintbrush tool with opacity 50%, flow 100 and hardness 0. I'm going to use the white color on the brush because white color reveals the effect, okay? And I'm going to start painting in the areas that need to be darker. So for example, I'm going to paint over here, and as you can see, I'm making this area dark. And in order to make things blend even better, I'm going to paint a little bit over the edges of the areas that I made them look brighter, okay? So I'm going to paint over the light areas over here and their edges, and this will make things blend even better throughout the whole frame. I'm going to paint here, I'm going to paint here. This area definitely needs some darkening, this area over here as well. Maybe over here, here, this area. I'm watching where the shadows are leaving and I'm just painting over this effect, okay? Now, if this effect is too strong, you can do a couple of things. You can actually use a lower opacity, for example, a 20% opacity, in order to have the brush strokes affect a lot less your photo, or you can go over here to the opacity slider and reduce the overall effect throughout the whole frame, okay? But I believe this looks quite nice, so I'm going again over here, I'm going to select this curves adjustment layer that makes these areas darker, and I'm going to use a live filter of Gaussian blur in order to blur this mask as well and make it blend better throughout the whole photo. All right, now let's see what we did. If we choose all these layers, this is before, quite flat, this is the after, okay, before and after. And let's see, with the two adjustment layers of curves type, this is before, look how flat the photo is, and this is after, okay, before and after. Now, if you use this before and after technique, you might notice that the light areas are kind of too bright, okay, looks kind of fake. So I'm going to double click over here, and I'm going to click and drag towards the center in order to make the effect less prominent. So if we use a before and after, now you will see that it looks a lot more realistic. Okay? So this photo looks great so far, but we need to do one final adjustment in order to bring everything together. And this is a contrast, let's say, edit of this photo. Let me tell you what I mean. Let me show you, I'm sorry, what I mean. I'm going to the topmost layer. I'm going to change the name of this curves adjustment layer before I move on into dark areas, so I remember what it does 2 months from now when I reopen this photo, if I need to do some editing. And it would be nice if I spelled the word areas correctly, okay? Now, let's throw a curves adjustment layer on top of everything else, and I'm going to do a classic S-curve for more contrast. So I'm going to click over here where these two lines intersect, and I'm going to click here where these two lines again intersect. I'm going to click and drag to the right, and maybe a little bottom. I'm going to click and drag to the left and upwards, okay? So this control point controls the highlights. As you can see, if I push it to the left and up, it's going to make the whites even whiter. And this control point controls the blacks. If I push it downwards and to the right, it's going to make everything really dark. So I need to assess the photo. Do I need to play around with the darks and the lights as well? Or I just need the lights to be a little more brighter? So I'm going to push the highlights to the left and upwards, and it looks quite nice. And maybe I will just give it a little more punch by dragging this control point slightly downwards, which will make eventually the dark areas just a tiny bit darker, okay? So there you have it. This is the original photo. It's okay, but it's quite flat. This is the original photo with just a black and white filter, quite flat. And this is the final photo with more punch, more contrast, more, let's say, drama. Now, if the dark areas are a little too dark for you and you lose detail, you can do two things. Thing number one, you can go to the dark areas curve, double click it, and push this control point upwards and to the left so you can reveal more detail from the dark areas. Or you can actually lower the overall opacity of this layer by going over here and lowering its opacity until you get the result that you want. But the key here is to experiment, okay? If you experiment and if you play around with these techniques for a couple of times, you are going to grasp the concept and you are going to know how to use each tool and technique in order to get the best out of your photos. And now this technique does not work only on landscapes. You can use it very much in every kind of situation and genre of photography that you want to add some black and white drama to it. It can be a portrait, it can be a landscape, it can be a commercial photo shoot, it can be a product photo shoot, whatever you need to add drama, or I should say it more correctly, whenever you need to add more drama to a black and white photo, this technique will save you. Now, that was it for today. Thank you very much for joining us and stay tuned because the season just started. We have a lot more tutorials coming your way. Subscribe to our newsletter. You will find the link down below and to our YouTube channel because we are going to inform you every time we publish a free weekly course just like this one, a tutorial. And if you want, you can give it a thumbs up because, as you know, it helps a ton with the YouTube algorithm. This is Strato Yanni from Illumis.com and that was the tutorial on how to create dramatic and cinematic black and white photos. See you at the next one next week. Take care.